Before your throne of mercy and your throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in times of need. Lord, we just worship you, we just give you praise, we honor you. We say, blessed be your holy name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Our Father and our God, we are here again, Lord, to fellowship, Lord, to learn at your feet. Father, I commit this day to your hands. Everyone listening, everyone watching, Lord, I bring them before your throne of mercy. Lord, that tonight, Lord, you will do something new in our lives. I pray tonight, Lord, that you will bless us. I pray tonight that as we call on you, as we cry to you, that you will hear us from heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I hand over this time to you, Holy Spirit. It's all about you. I pray that you have your way and take prayer meetings and take control. Let your presence, oh Lord, reach out to everyone. Lord, as we call on you tonight, we pray that you give ears to our prayers. We pray that you pay attention to our prayers tonight, Lord. In your mercy, you will hear us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we worship. Lord, we give you praise. Blessed be your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we praise you. In Jesus' mighty name. Hello, my dear friends. Good evening, good day wherever you are, and welcome to the Journey to Marriage. I'm so glad you could join me tonight. I'm so glad you could take some of those precious time of yours and spend with me. If you're just joining us for the first time, we've simply been looking at what singles need to know, do, put in place as they journey to marriage. But tonight, we're going to be praying and committing our marital journey and marital lives into the hands of the Almighty God. And tonight, I'm going to be encouraging someone. I don't know who the Lord wants to talk to tonight, but I know that there's someone that the Lord wants to reach. Tonight, I just want to remind you that God has not forsaken or forgotten you. Now, you may be wondering, everyone around you is getting married. A lot of people are getting married, but it seems like it's not really happening for you. And you may be feeling rejected, dejected, that things are not really working out. But I'm here to remind you tonight, to let you know that God has not forgotten you. God is doing things behind the scene for you. You may be so downcasted right now, and everything might seem like there is no way out. But tonight, I want to encourage you. I want to tell you there is a way out for you. I want to tell you tonight, as we pray, that you press in, and you will see what the Lord will do. Before we proceed tonight, I want to ask you, please invite your friends right now, because God is set to do amazing things. God is set to do wonderful things. So go ahead, invite someone. Let them join. Let us pray together. Bible says, wherever two or three shall gather and agree, that God responds to prayer of agreement. So you want to be agreeing regarding your marital destiny tonight. And I know that God will answer us from heaven. I know that the heavens are already open. So go ahead and invite someone. As I quickly read something to you from the book of Jeremiah 29 verse 11. Jeremiah 29 verse 11. If you have your Bibles, you can bring your Bibles close, because we are going to be reading from the Word of God a lot tonight. I just want to encourage you from the Word of God. The Bible says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace, not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." That's what the Bible is telling you tonight. God is telling you that the thoughts that He has towards you, they are thoughts of peace, not of evil, because He wants to give you a future. He wants to give you an expected end. And that expected end, it includes wife, it includes husband, it includes children, it includes marriage. Whatever you're looking for, God has already planned it. It's not towards you of good, it is not of evil. So tonight, I just want to encourage you. I don't know, maybe perhaps it just looks like nothing is working out around you. Nothing is working out in your marital destiny. Nothing is working out in your relationship. Nothing is working out in your career. It may look like nothing is working out. But I want to tell you tonight, God have thoughts of peace towards you. Thoughts of good thoughts towards you. Good plans to give you an expected end. Where you are right now is not your end. It's just a way you are going through. I don't know who you are listening to me, feeling downcast, feeling all alone, feeling lost. I want to tell you what you're going through right now is not the end. It is just a passing through. Why don't you look at yourself wherever you are and tell yourself, I am just passing through. This is not my end. This is not my destiny. What I'm going through right now, the setbacks, the delays, is just a pass through for me. And I'm going to get to the expected end that the Lord has for me. Why don't you say that to yourself? Just say to yourself, what I'm going through right now is not my end, is not my destination. God have good plans for me to give me a good future and a hope, and that includes my marriage. Come on, confess that to yourself. And you know, there's power in your mouth. Whatever you're going to speak tonight, whatever you're going to say tonight, that's what's going to happen to you. Because guess what? The Bible says that life and death are in the power of the tongue. I'm just encouraging you before we go on to pray. Because I want you to pray with the whole of your heart. I want you to pray with the whole of your mind. I want you to pray tonight like your life depends on it. I don't know where you are. If you're somewhere that you cannot pray, I'd like to ask you right now to just get somewhere that you know you'll be able to pray, because I know that God wants to do great things in your life. I know that God wants to do mighty things in your life. Like I read to you in the book of Jeremiah 29 and verse 11, the Bible says, for I know the thoughts I have towards you, says the Lord, not man, not says your father, not says your mother, not says your uncle, not says your friend, but said the Lord, I know the plan that I have towards you. I have the plan, the thought of peace, to prosper you, to give you a future and to give you hope. Dear friends, God has a plan for you. God has not forsaken you. God has not forgotten you. It doesn't matter how it looks right now. I am telling you, according to what is written concerning you in the word of God, according to what God has said concerning you, He has good plans, and that plan is to give you a future and a hope. You may be wondering, how can this be true when nothing seems to be working around me? How can you sit there and tell me God has good plans for me when all my mates have gotten married, or when my mates are progressing, or even my younger ones have gotten married? How can I believe that God has good plans for me? I want to tell you one thing tonight, that everybody have their own timetable before God. So don't measure your life because somebody has something you don't have. Does not mean that you're not going to have it. Your own time is coming. Your own turn is coming. Yes, they may have had it, but that was not your own time. Focus on your own life and your own timetable before God. A lot of singles go around feeling rejected, feeling dejected, feeling downcasted because they feel, oh, somebody has something I don't have. Oh, she got married. I'm not yet married. Oh, my friend got engaged. I'm not yet engaged. I want to encourage you tonight. Don't be moved by that. Your time is coming. You have a timetable before God. They have a timetable before God. So stay focused tonight. Stay focused on your life and stop comparing. Stop the unhealthy comparison between your life and everyone else. They may have today. It doesn't mean that you're not going to have it. I want to tell you, the first house that is built in a town is not necessarily the most beautiful one. In 10 years' time, someone else is going to come and build a better house. They may have it today, but in 1 year, 2 years' time, God will make you to have even a better one. So focus on your life. God have good plans for you. So I want you right now, wherever you are, with this understanding, irrespective of what you're going through, and just begin to thank God for your life. Lift your voice this morning and say, Lord, I thank you for my life. Now you're not wondering about anyone else. You're just wondering about yourself. You're just thanking God for yourself. Don't care about everybody getting married. praise God for them, but I'm thanking God for my life because I have my own calendar before God, because my own time is coming. Lift your voice tonight and tell Him, Lord, I thank you for my life. I thank you for the good plans that you have for me. Come on, dear friends, lift your voice and make that prayer, because you know what you thank God for, you make Him to multiply it, you make Him to bless it. You cannot keep complaining and expect God to work out a miracle. You have to be thankful. The Bible says, in everything, let us give thanks to God. Yes, give Him thanks. You're not married. You may not even be engaged. You may not even be in a relationship. But give Him praise that you are alive. Give Him praise that you are marriageable. There are many people that want to get married, but they are in the hospital. They're in the mental asylum homes. There are so many places that nobody will even go there to go and marry them. But there you are. You want to get married. You're not mad. You're not sick. You don't have anything. You're doing very well. So why don't you lift your voice and thank the Lord for that? Lift your voice this morning. Father, I just want to thank you for all these dear ones. I want to thank you for their lives. I want to thank you for their destiny. I want to thank you. Lord, I want to give you praise tonight for everything that concerns them. Father, they may not be married, but Lord, you have good plans for them. They may not be married, but they are alive. Lord, it is only the living that can even start thinking about marriage. If they are not living, they will not even be considering marriage. For the mere fact, Lord, that you have kept them alive, I return all the praise to you. Lord, I give you glory because their life counts. Their life matters to you. It's because you have good plans and good things for them. That's why you have kept them alive. I thank you for their lives. I join my voice with their voices, and we lift up our voices together to say, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we honor you. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we praise you. Thank you for everything about them. Thank you for everything about their destiny. We give you glory and honor and praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, sometimes people say, why should I thank God? Things are not working out for me. My dear, you're still alive. Do you know how many people died today? Do you know how many people died yesterday? Better, more educated, more beautiful, more handsome, better than you, more well-to-do. But they are all dead. Now that they are dead, they cannot even be thinking about marriage. So there you are, you are alive. So you have reasons. And why you are alive is because God still has good plans for you. Because God still have a purpose for your existence. Because God still have plans to better your life, to make everything He has promised you come to pass. So that is one reason, in case you're still wondering, why should I thank God? I'm giving you just one reason. The mere fact that you are alive, that you are well, that you are marriageable, lift your voice and tell Him, Lord, I thank you. You're not better than them that are dead. You're not better than them that have gone on to the grave. It is the mercy of the Lord that has kept you. So for that mercy, I want you to lift your voice and tell Him, Lord, I thank you, because I am alive is a sign that you're not done with me yet, irrespective of what I'm going through. I am alive means that you still have good plans for me. It means that there is still something that you want to do in my life. Lift your voice for that and give Him praise. But I want to thank you for everyone listening or who will listen. I want to thank you because we are here, because you still have a good plan for us. You still have thoughts to prosper us. You still have a good end for us. But I want to thank you because you're not better than them that are dead. You're not better than them that are in the grave. Lord, we give you praise and we give you glory. We give you honor and we give you worship. We thank you, Lord. We give you glory. Father, we thank you and we praise you. We honor you, Lord. We magnify your name. We say, may your name be highly exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, dear friends, that being alive is the greatest gift. For being alive alone is the greatest gift from the Almighty God. It means that God has not forsaken you. It means that God has not forgotten you. If God has forgotten about you, believe me, you will not wake up and you wouldn't have woken up this morning. It's because He has not forgotten you. That's why you're still there. You know, now I want to talk to you for a few seconds here before we say the next prayers. Now, your life is not about marriage alone. There's so many things about your life. It's not about marriage alone. So don't be downcasted because you're not married. A lot of people have made their lives about marriage. Marriage is a good thing. It's a blessing from God. But that is not what your life is all about. There is more to your life than husband or wife. Believe me, there is more to it. And when your appointed time comes, God is going to bless you with the bone of your bones and the flesh of your flesh. Now, I counsel a lot of, sometimes during some of the counseling sessions, rejections. You hear them simply, I hear singles telling me, oh, I don't have anyone in my life. My life is so bad. I do not have any man. I do not have any woman. I've really been praying to God. God has not really, God has not settled me. My life is meaningless. My life is hopeless. My friends are getting married. My younger sister just got married. My younger brother is about to get married. And they feel so downcast. But I want to encourage you tonight. Your life is more than that. You have better purpose, better thing until God blesses you with your husband or your wife. Do something good with your life. Do something better with your life. Better your life. Live life, singles. Live life, my friends. Some singles are not living life. They're just like hanging in there, just waiting for one man or one woman to come and rescue them. No, that's not what God has created you for. That's not all that God has created you for. Don't get me wrong. Marriage is a good thing. Marriage is a blessing, but marriage is supposed to be an addition to your life. Marriage is not supposed to be what your life is all about. Believe me, you may be thinking, oh, when I get married, I'm going to be happy. I'm going to feel fulfilled and all of that. But believe me, there are so many people that are married and they wish that they are not married. They are not fulfilled. They are not happy. Because that's not, marriage is not what all your life should be about. So I want you to lift your voice tonight and tell him, Lord, help me to make the best out of my life, whether married or not. Let me live a fulfilled life, whether I'm married or not, whether I'm engaged or not. Help me, Lord, to be happy with the life that you have given to me, with the purpose, with my calling. There's so many things that, you know, God has put inside of you. You have a purpose, and it's just not about marriage. You have a calling. God has a reason. God was not lazy when he created. He was not just looking for something to do. He created you because there was a purpose for which he created you. So why don't you lift your voice and tell him, Lord, I'm going to live my life. I'm going to live happy. I'm going to fulfill destiny. In as much as I'm waiting to be married, I'm not just going to waste my life just sitting idle, wasting my life. Father, help me to invest in my life. Help me to invest in myself. Help me to explore. Help me to evolve. Help me to develop. Help me to grow. Help me, Lord, to be about my purpose. In the name of Jesus, lift your voice and make that prayer. Many people are just wasting their life, just sitting around, just hanging in there, waiting for one man or one woman to come and rescue them. But why don't you pray that the Lord himself will help you tonight, that you will not waste your life or your destiny, that you'll be making something meaningful out of that life while you wait for your marriage, for your partner, for your right soulmate to come along. Lift your voice and make that prayer tonight. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, help me to fulfill purpose. Help me to fulfill destiny. Help me to live life to the fullest as I wait for my soulmate to come around. Lord, don't allow me to waste my life or my destiny. Lift your voice and make that prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray for these dear ones listening to me tonight. I pray, God, that, Lord, they will fulfill purpose and destiny. Their life will not be wasted. Lord, that, Lord, they will not feel inferior. They will not feel insecure. They will not feel 50% complete simply because they are not married. They are still waiting for you to bless them with the right person. I pray that, Lord, you will teach them to be joyful with their lives, to live life to the fullest, to evolve, to develop, to mature, to grow in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God Almighty, that, Lord, you will help them, Lord, that you will help them, because for each and every one of them, you have a purpose, you have a calling, you have something that you have created them to do. Aside marriage, I pray that they will be pursuing the purpose and your goal for their lives, even as they wait on you to bless them with the bone of their bones and the flesh of their flesh, in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't waste your life. I don't know who is listening to me, just waiting, just hanging, just waiting for someone. If only I can get married today, my life will change. If only I can get married, this will happen, I will be happy. You can't be happy on your own. I'm here to encourage someone. You can't be happy, and when that person comes, you'll be happier. Because they should come as an addition to your life and not what your life consists of. I want you to lift your voice again tonight and pray. And tell him, Lord, remember me. Jeremiah 29:11, I remind you again. He says, for I know the thoughts that I have towards you. Thoughts of peace, not of evil, to give an expected end. I don't know how long you have been trusting God, how long you have been hoping on Him, how long you have been praying, why don't you lift your voice again tonight and tell Him, Lord, this is my own year. Lord, in this year 2018, Lord, let it be my own year to get married in the name of Jesus. Decree it, believe it, it shall come to pass for you. Don't start, don't think to know how God is going to do it. God can do anything, anyhow, anytime. Yours is just to ask. The Bible says, ask and you shall receive. So why don't you ask Him tonight, Lord, remember me in this season. Regarding my marriage, remember me in this season. Regarding my marital destiny, remember me in this season. I know that you have not forsaken me, but Lord, I'm just reminding you, remember me, remember me, remember me, remember me, remember me. Lift your voice and make that prayer. I am praying for you as well, Father, in the name of Jesus. For all these dear ones, I pray, Lord, that this will be their season. Remember them, oh God, remember them, remember them. Let the book of remembrance be open on their behalf in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, please, God, I pray that this year, 2018, will be their own year. That, Lord, just like you did it, you're doing it for everyone there and there. That, Lord, you will remember them, you will look upon them with your eyes of mercy, and you will settle them maritally in the mighty name of Jesus. As many of them desiring, oh God, to be settled, Lord, to be maritally settled in a good home with a good spouse, Lord, that to be someone that will help them, and they will help, and they will build their lives together. I pray that you will settle them. I pray that you will settle them. I pray that you will settle them. I pray that you will settle them in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift your voice, strength, and decree and say, make this prayer. Say, I will not struggle to get married. I will not struggle to find my right mate. I will not struggle to find the bone of my bones or the flesh of my flesh. If you're a lady, say, I will not struggle to be located. I shall not be eating. My right soulmate will find me in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and make that prayer. You cannot be eating. Whatever is covering you, whatever is covering that is not making you to be seen, I pray that the fire of God will fall upon such things in the mighty name of Jesus. Make up your, lift your voice. Say, Lord, I will not struggle to be located. I shall not be hidden from the bone of my bones. I will not be hidden. And if you're a man, say, I will not struggle to locate the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh. Lift your voice and make that prayer tonight. Father, I'm praying for all these dear ones listening to me. The Bible says in Genesis 2, after you made man, you said it was not good for a man to be alone, that you will make him a helpmeet. Lord, and you made a woman out of his ribs. Lord, I pray that for all these dear ones, they will not struggle to find the bone of their bones and the flesh of their flesh. Lord, the ladies will not struggle to be seen. They will not struggle to be located in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, God, that divinely you will connect them. Divinely you will connect each and every one of them in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to read something for you, because I'm here to encourage someone tonight. In the book of Isaiah 34 and verse 16, I want to tell you what the word of God says about you. It says, search from the book, I'm reading Isaiah 34, 16. Search from the book of the Lord and read. Not one of these shall fail. Not one shall lack a mate. That is what the word of God is saying concerning. He said, not one shall lack. Some version says, not one shall want a mate. That is, you're not permitted to struggle to find your partner. You're not permitted. The Bible says, not one shall want or lack. God made you for someone. God made someone out of you. So you're not permitted to struggle. This is not man speaking. It is God speaking. He said, search from the book of the Lord and read. Not one of these shall fail. That's the word of God, cannot fail. He said, search from the book of the Lord and read. Not one of these shall fail. Not one shall lack a mate. For my mouth have commanded it, and his spirit gathereth them. For the mouth of the Lord has commanded it. Friends, this is concerning you, that you will not want your mate. You will not struggle to you will not lack your mate. Because when God made you, he made, if you're a lady, he made you out of some man's rib. If you're a man, a rib was taken from from you to make a woman. So there is someone out there for you. Do not believe the lie that, oh, there are too many women, there are few men and all of that. That is not true. God made you for someone, and he has assured you from his word in Isaiah 34 verse 16 that you will not want, you will not lack your mate. So I want you to lift your voice based on, with reference to that word of God, and say, Father, will not want my mates in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and make that prayer. I hope you're praying, friends, because the ears of God are attentive to us tonight. Lift your voice and say, Lord, I will not want my mates. I will not struggle to be married. I don't know, maybe your parents struggled before they got married. Maybe your elder sister struggled before she got married. Your brother struggled before he got married. But your case is different. I decree to you, your case is different. Lift your voice and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I will not struggle. I break that yoke. I break that barrier of struggle. I break it in the name of Jesus. As for me, I will not struggle. I will not struggle. I will not struggle. I will not struggle. Father, I thank you for everyone listening to me right now. Lord, as many of them that seems like they are struggling to settle down, Lord, they are ready, everything is ready, but things seem not just to be working out. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, we decree according to your word in Isaiah 34 verse 16 that no one shall want a mate. That means them, that includes them. So we decree according to your word in the name of Jesus, Lord, these dear ones will not struggle to be married. These dear ones will not want their mate in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I decree that for this year once, your case is different. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, make a way, make a way, make a way, make a way. Matera Bados, Keteria Lama, in this year, 2018, make a way for them, oh God, to be joyfully married, happily settled in their homes. In the mighty name of Jesus, in that same vein, I want you to pray. The Bible says, no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper, and every tongue that will rise up against you in judgment that you shall condemn. Friends, if you're not praying,